Hello, everyone. So I've been moved to make a video. I'm not really sure what we're going to talk about, but we've got like an emperor and a king of wands flying out decks while I'm shuffling them. Okay. I don't know if I'm going to use. Oh, look at this. Money, money, money. And dating. You see this full moon? I feel like somebody's gonna ask you guys out, okay? I feel like you guys are like, I just heard back in this back on the saddle again. That's how it goes. What is this? Friendships, yeah. Meeting new people. Yeah, okay, this is like, look, something is changing here. Let's see what the heck this is. What's back here? Ooh, passion. So this could be a friend. It's like taking it up a notch. All right, I was not even gonna use this deck, so I'm gonna, ooh, open relationships. Yeah, so this is, see, it's like new love. So I'm not really sure what's going on. I feel like, well, what I'm getting is dating, okay? Mingling, okay. You could meet somebody that's in an open relationship, or they want to have an open relationship with you, or this is how it starts, okay? But they're saying something about the king to the emperor, okay? It's like, and in that emperor, it was in here. Let's see. Let's just see what goes on. Okay, what's the main focus here for the collective? Patience, putting work into something like a, and here's this chakra, okay? So there's I'm hearing generating chakra development. Okay, so did you guys just see that orb? Anyway, generating chakra development. Okay, so this is because look, this is what's being manifested is a new beginning. What is this? Oh, speaking of new beginnings, because this is over, okay? It's I just started hearing Harry Styles' Sign of the Times, but I also heard for a split second, Florence and Machine, the something, you know, that happy song, the one about the dog days are over. Yeah. Okay, so let's see. Okay, the recent past. Somebody's growing a mustache, I heard. Something about your mustache. Like there's like a mustache, trying to grow a mustache. Could be like a very thin looking mustache. Okay, so I don't know. That's I feel yeah, somebody's going you're going through a spiritual transformation, like a spiritual upgrade. Like this is the reason why you're finding yourself so agitated and irritated because it's like an opportunity for you to work on yourself some more. Okay. It's like are you know that you don't want to go back to these things. There's but there's like there's something here. I don't know if this is just a specific. I just there's somebody trying to grow a mustache, okay? And it's like I feel like whoever this is, it's like you're trying to find a the and it could just be like a metaphor, okay? But like as in like because this person is growing, okay? This is like patience, okay? Tending to something, and you know like when you have a mustache or you know when you men are like growing out facial hair, it like takes time. It's not like you say, oh, you know, you just don't shave for one day and it's there. You know, it's like you have to allow it to grow. So I feel like this person is like trying to, yeah, like find their footing. Yeah, see, they something's like broaden their horizons. Maybe you recently moved, maybe you are moving. So strange, right? About the. I just feel like this person's changing, okay? Things in their life are changing. It's like they're saying on a molecular level, okay? So it's happening first on the inside, okay? So it's not like everybody doesn't understand why you're doing the things that you're doing, or like they can't see what you see, because, you know, I don't want to say like they're not on your level, like as in like an egoic thing. It's just like they see the world differently. Okay, so we'll just keep it like that. All right. So, but you're changing. So, and it's happening to you. Yeah, they're saying energetic upgrades, and you're going through. Ooh. Okay. You're getting upgraded. All right. And then, like, as, but it's happening on the inside first before like everything that you're doing is going to like start showing, materializing on the outside. Okay. That's what they said. So they told me just to say it how they say it. All right. Okay. Yeah. You could have recently walked away from something, or you're contemplating walking away. It's like, 'cause you've made a decision that you're leaving the past behind. Okay. But I don't feel yet like there could still be like some planning, some plotting, you know, like plotting as in like, not like anything sneaky, but although it's like just sneaky because you haven't revealed your moves to everybody yet, but it's like, you're still processing the things that you want to do as you move forward in your life. Okay. I feel like there's a lot of, okay, I'm hearing another song. Dun, 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 dun. Take me away. Wait, I don't know what song that is. Yeah, see, it's like here's the ending. Yeah, see, it's like wherever you're going or whatever it is that you want to do, it's like there's still some more information needed. There's still some more development. I'm hearing psychic development. So maybe some of you are trying to understand, you know, what's really going on as far as like your energetic upgrades, because you can feel it, but I feel like some of you are a little bit freaked out by it. Okay, but really there's like why? Like they're yours, you know, like everybody's got them. It's just whether or not you choose to like tap into it and like develop it. And you know, and in order, I know that for me, like in the allowance of, you know, it comes with freedom. And that freedom is the release of what other people think, okay? I feel like a lot of you are very bored by the people around you, okay? And so, like, you could just be showing up. And it's because that you're supposed to be expanding your surround. I don't want to say supposed to be, but you are being moved to expand your horizons, okay? Your circle is changing. I heard again. Don't feel bad about it. All right. Listen, you're living your life for your soul development, not anybody else's. Okay. Although there may be, yeah, see endings there. It's like she's going into, expanding her horizons. They just said new horizons. Yeah. Because it's like, this is over. The dog days are over. That's that song. You've been waiting for this a long time. Somebody's waiting for you too on the other side of this. Look, your emotional fulfillment. Dang, this is big, but I feel like somebody, yeah, see, this is your justice. This is what you deserve, okay? Look, and here's the devil. I feel like you're being released from the devil. You could be surrounded by a lot of like toxic people, just people that are like very codependent on each other, or maybe that's just like the lifestyle that you're breaking free from, you know, people all up in your business. Yeah, I just heard inquiring minds want to know. Yeah. it's going to take a lot of strength for you to walk away from this because look, like this is, look at how handsome this devil is, okay? They say the devil, what is it, shows himself as a gentleman, will always present himself as a gentleman. So it's like very easily to be swayed because maybe whoever you have to walk away from, for some of you, I feel like it's several people, okay? They could be, you know, decent people, but they're not living the life you want, you know? And there's no need, like, I feel like whoever's resonating with this, like, you have bigger dreams. And not that those people that you're surrounded with, dreams aren't meaningful. You know, their life is fulfilling, but it's, you're being called for bigger things because you're meant for bigger things. Like, that's your, it's just what you're being called for. You've worked through many stages to be released from the devil. That's what I'm hearing. Don't feel bad about it, but also don't get an ego about it. It doesn't mean that you're freaking like, yeah, humble and kind, okay? And they say, at least I've heard before, humble people don't talk about the fact that they're humble, okay? They don't even like think of it. Like they don't even think that they have to say it or prove it at all. They're not even thinking about like, well, what would a humble person do? No, they just are. You understand what I'm saying? So somebody's got kind of like, I feel like that's why this justice card came out in reverse with the devil, because I feel like somebody's kind of getting a little bit cocky or is getting a little bit too big for their britches, like thinks they know something. Okay, so I don't know, that's for somebody, but it's like, it doesn't happen like that. All right, if you think you know something, you don't know shit, bud. All right, like, I know for me, like, I'm just supposed to leave it at that. Yeah, you got to look at this situation from a different perspective, okay? Because it's like, I feel like somebody's hanging themselves out to dry here. Yeah, they're doing a lot of reflection. Yeah, see, I'm telling you, people want to walk away from, because the Eight of Cups, it's like you walk away to the Ten of Cups, okay? To your own emotional fulfillment. Somebody wants to walk away to the sun because like wherever they're at, it's like, it's okay. Okay. But it's not like whoever this is that's walking away, it's like, you can't picture living your life in this mundane way every single day. And for some people, like, that's like great. They love doing that, you know, but other people, no. For other people, it's like, yeah, look, this just shows somebody's getting a love offer. It's like you're opening up. Yeah, see, it's just like, yeah. Let me see. Tell me about this Two of Wands. There is a love offer, but it's like opening up to love. Did you see that orb? Yeah, see, look. Healing, somebody's recuperating because, you know, it's like, it's sad. I feel like you care about these people. You know, their feelings are going to be hurt when you walk away from them, but you're meant to stick out, babe. Okay. You don't have to feel stuck about this. Like you're keeping yourself stuck. There's nothing to feel guilty about. You were chose to live this life. That's it. It's just like, you know, you thank them kindly. And yeah, look, some of you are very wise, okay? And you know that you're meant for bigger things. And I feel like this is you've been being prepared for this, okay? The last 7 years could have been like torture, but it's like you've been building. It's like, this is, it's like, they just showed me this as like somebody's like last 7 years. So it's like, you found out how deeply your roots were planted, okay? And maybe outwardly this didn't show, but inside you knew you knew you were a rock. Like, you knew that you were solid. You knew that you were a tree that wasn't, like, going to fall, okay? But everybody looking on the outside, like, saw you in a completely different way, okay? They may still look at you in a completely different way, but I'm telling you, this is all changing, okay? I feel like you can probably sense this coming for yourself as well. Yeah, I'm just hearing upgrade, okay? Changing. Your life is, yeah. See, I told you, you can sense this coming. You're preparing for it, okay? And I feel like there's going to, like, I'm hearing softening the blows. Like, so you may be walking away from relationships. You may be, but in a gentle and kind way. It's not like you're ending them like, this is over. It's just like, I feel like you're going to be telling people, like, you know, it's just time for me to move on. You know, this no longer fits into my schedule. This no longer, you know, works for how I'm living my life, you know, something like that. Because see, you've been being prepared, especially these last 7 years. You've been being prepared for this. And it's, yeah, it just feels like someone's been being prepared and you know this. And it's like somebody's life is going to be completely turned upside down. And it all is, it's like, you see how she has her heart out here? She's resting. Like, you've been healing your heart. Okay. Whatever's happened this last 7 years, it's all been about healing and psychic development. That's what I heard. Yeah. Look, you got a lot of people watching you, or whoever this is resonating for. Cause I'm not, I can't, this isn't for everybody. Okay. You're unbothered. Okay. You're unbothered. You have a lot of people that just watch you just to talk shit about you, but you don't care. And you know it. Okay. Because why? Because saw that high priestess, you're the high priestess. Okay. I know for me personally, like when I'm doing readings, like I see people's faces and sometimes I don't know who they are. And sometimes I know exactly who they are. So these people would never tell me that they watch me on YouTube. Okay. But I know. Okay. So anyway, but that's what's happening here. Okay. It's like, you've been disconnecting yourself probably for the last 7 years from people, places, and things. Like, just you've been, looking at life different. You're just changing. Down to, yeah, see, and rebuilding. And look here, seven of pentacles and the three of pentacles makes the ten of pentacles. It's like what you've been doing and what you've been working on, it's like you're changing. It's generational. It's legacy. You're laying down a new legacy. You're building a legacy, okay? But you're doing this with others, okay? Maybe not so much like physically, but working with others energetically. You know, like how, yeah, they're saying like grid workers. Like, you know, maybe if you've been recently moved to another area, it's because, like, you know, they need you to like ground your energy in that area. You know, it's like, and that's how we're all working together, you know? You could be waking up to the fact that you are a starseed, okay? I'm hearing like visitation, like you've been receiving visitation, but maybe you haven't like processed that yet as like true visitation or, but I mean, it's a lot. It's a lot to take in, you know? Yeah. See, somebody's stressing out about it. Okay. And, but you're finding your balance. Yeah. Look, see, this is recognition. This is about like taking a chance on the world to come. That's what I just heard. Okay. So it's like the future, on your future. Like, how do you want to live your life? Are you living it for them? Like, as in everybody else, or are you going to live for you? Okay. Somebody's about like definitely choosing themselves, but just like trying to leave everybody else like on the best possible terms as possible, you know, like on the best terms possible. Because maybe in the past, you would just cut people out of your life, okay? But it's like, it's not that you never have to see these people again, but it's just like, maybe not like every day or every week, you know what I mean? So, yeah, humble and kind, humble and kind. Yeah, see, here's this devil and the heartache. Because it's like, I feel like in the past, you could have sacrificed your own heartache, you know, like sacrificed yourself, like you would live in heartache to kind of like save other people from hurting. And the universe is like, no. Okay, this is what you've been working on. This is why you've been doing so much healing and letting go and processing. Okay, you're no longer living your life as like a puppet on the string. It's like living like this has been killing you. So let's see. They're telling me to look at this. Yeah. Ten of Pentacles. Okay, this is like financial stability. This is like the King of Pentacles is grounded. He's able to make decisions. And this is what you're waking up to, is like the fact that, you know, like maybe before you've doubted yourself or second guessed your decision making, but this is you like no longer doubting who and what you are. You see that big pentacle? Okay. This is also, some of you are being offered a new job. Okay. Just, this is a new opportunity coming in. Okay. And here's this, I think like, there's this dog here, okay, but it happens to be a wolf, okay? There's this wolf moon, this Leo full moon that's coming. It's pretty much here. I was reading about it, and they actually call it, like, the wolf moon, okay? So this is this wolf here, but this also is, who's ever this resonating with this and moving through this, it's like you have a lot of haters. Like you can feel this, okay? It's been a heaviness. It's like you understand, it's heartbreaking, okay? Because yeah, you're really sticking out and you're about to stick out more, okay? And I feel like for a long time you shrank your shine, okay? But it's like you're finally releasing the guilt. Yeah, you're moving on and moving forward to your fresh start. Okay. And you're protecting it. Everybody doesn't get to come. Okay. You're going to be very cautious about who, because you've worked too hard to heal, to be free, to free yourself. You've created what's coming for you. Like you didn't just create, but in order to create it and in order for it to appear, it's like you have to develop the mindset that you deserve it. Okay. And then somebody's done this. Okay. And this is you, King of Pentacles. Okay. Yeah. You're ending up on top. Okay. This is, an offer from somebody extremely stable and willing to work with you. Okay. So for some of you, this is like going to end up in a long-term, commitment, either through, it's like the job that you're going to have for the rest of your life, but it's like a job that's like emotionally fulfilling, or this is a connection. Yeah, this is so funny. I just heard, this is what it sounds like when pigs fly instead of when doves cry. Okay. So it's like whatever's happening here or what's, but it's been happening. That's what everybody else around you doesn't know, is that this isn't something that's happening overnight for you, but nobody understands, or they didn't, it's like, because it's been happening on the inside of you. Like, you've been changing, okay? Your thought processes, the way that you look at yourself, you've been doing so much inner work, and it's all about to fucking go kaboom, like on the outside, and everybody's gonna see you shine. Everybody's gonna see you shine. And right now there's like this stage of like, just kind of like, yeah, see, it's like wrapping your mind around the fact that, okay, because this is the Five of Swords, okay? Five of Swords is about, it can be manipulation. It can be like, you know, words going back and forth. I'm not even going to lie, but I mean, and you already know this, like you have some fucking haters, okay? People that just feel like they think that you're being, acting like you're better than them, because possibly you don't talk to them anymore. You have people in your life that just fucking hate seeing you shine and seeing you happy. And that's really sad. I'm not telling you anything you don't already know. Okay. And it's like, you've been working on your own self-esteem so that you can feel comfortable. Like you're getting to a place where you're letting go of the guilt of making everybody else feel uncomfortable because you shine bright like a diamond. And the thing is that everybody could shine bright like a diamond, but it's like, you have to do the work. You know what I'm saying? Like the diamonds, like what is it? They're covered in like coal or something. So it's like, they're not just like born a diamond. It's like, no, you gotta like go in there and you gotta find it, and you know, and then like it's takes work. And what everybody else hasn't seen is all the work and effort that you've been putting into yourself. Because I feel like outwardly, whatever you've had or done outwardly hasn't been very impressive. But you know what? They say character building is not something truly sought after, you know, it's not seen as something that's, you know, like a prize. Boss up and change your life. That's what the hell you did. You went total transformation because you started loving yourself. It's like, yeah, I'm hearing, I found the greatest. I'm not going to sing Whitney Houston. I cannot sing Whitney Houston. But the greatest love of all inside of herself. That's who she found, okay? The hair font. This is you, like, rising up. This is you, the teacher. Listen, this is not for everybody. This is somebody that has been quietly rising. This is why you're getting this new beginning. Okay, you're going to have a time to celebrate. Your time for celebrate, it's like all lining up. This is, it's something meant for you. It's all been about divine timing. Look. Kaboom. You're going to meet your person, okay? It could be whoever you meet could have, like, children on your own. Like, you both could have, like, have your own children, and then you come together, and it's kind of like the Brady Bunch. Yeah, I just started hearing the Brady Bunch. So, yeah. It's like somebody's just getting it all here. And it's like, I'm looking at this. It's like this person is no longer refusing to see that they deserved it, that they have deserved it all along. Like, this is, they're meant to be. You've like been pondering your life, looking back, reflecting on everything. And it's like, I just heard, I finally learned to let it go. Oh my God. This is some massive fucking healing, dude. This is like, that's from that that song, that John Mayer song. I can't think of which one it is, but I heard it. This is you Because as the King of Swords, like, able to see things from a higher perspective, you know, able to look out upon your life and your decisions and see like how your decisions in the past have, or your heartache has become like your strength. Okay, it's made you a warrior. Okay, I feel like, yeah, look, you're releasing yourself. You see this, you're becoming one with your higher self. This is you in line with your soul, your soul's purpose, your soul's journey, without hesitation, without guilt, without shame. Everybody doesn't get to come. And that doesn't mean that you're like, you know, walking away like a bitch, but it's just like when you need to say no, you say no. King of Swords is not afraid to say no. And you're saying no because it's for the highest good of yourself, and not in a selfish way, but it's just like, no, you know? I will not be silenced anymore. I will not be guilted into doing anything anymore. I will not allow myself to feel or respond in a small manner anymore. Where is that card? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Boss up and change your life. This isn't about trying. Okay, this person is doing it, all right? You got one more move up your sleeve. And it's like, I literally feel like this move changes everything. It gives you that fresh start that you've been waiting for. Yeah, see? You've been trying to figure it out. Okay, you've been trying, you kind of been acting a little confused, you know, because the past and the future have kind of been playing like tug of war with you. But no, you make a decision and then boom, you make a decision to walk away, and then it's like kaboom. Look, see? Kaboom. You leave anything that stresses you out behind. Why? Because you're the high priestess, male or female, like you're about it. You know. Nobody knows more than you what's best for you. I say that all the time. Nobody knows. This is you trusting the divine, trusting yourself. Like, whoa, this is powerful. One with yourself, okay? And because you've become one with yourself, look, someone's coming towards you, okay? This is a card of victory. This is a card of like spiritual awakening. This is balance. This is so freaking beautiful, you guys. I read for rock stars, okay? But again, I will tell you, like, this is not a reading for everybody, but you will know. You will know. You're probably bawling or like just, I don't know. This is just an amazing reading, and I'm honored to bring it to you. So I hope you have an amazing day, and I am still doing readings on the donation basis. So if you're interested in a reading, please reach out to me. All my information is in the description box. Bye. Have a great day.